Have you ever used the Forever block to make a never-ending render loop like this? This is the code to my video on how to draw shapes. If you're interested, I'll link that in the card above. When we run this code, it works exactly as expected. However, the loop includes some rendering overhead that may make your program laggy and slow. In this video, I'm going to show you why this code is not efficient and how to improve it. To highlight the problem and see the details of the drawing process, let's add a wait after line drawings in this code. So when you run the code, it waits 0.2 seconds after rendering each side. Can you spot the problem now? The loop is actually drawing the same shape over and over again. And this happens many times per second. To see this more clearly, let's first remove the wait block and then create a counter variable. And let's call it number of renders. This is to check how frequently the shape is drawn. Add this variable at the beginning of the code and set it to 0. Then change it by 1 each time the shape is drawn. Let's test it. You can see the code keeps drawing the shape until you press the stop button. Now the question is, do we need to draw the same shape over and over? Of course not. We need to draw the shape only once, and that is when the settings are changed. Which means when the number, length, or color of the sides is changed, we need to draw the shape. We can combine the values of these three properties and make a string that holds the settings together. And instead of drawing the shape over and over, we compare the current and previous value of this string and only draw the shape when the current value is different from the previous one. So let's see how to implement this to improve the performance. To do this, we define two new variables for tracking the changes in the settings. The first variable is current, which stores the combined settings when a property is changed. And the second variable, called previous, that shows the settings of the last drawing. Initially, set the previous to 0 and add it at the beginning of your code. Then, join the values of length, sides, and color properties, and store the result in the current variable. Now we compare the previous and current variables, and in case they are not equal, we need to redraw the shape. Note that the cost of building and comparing two variables is much, much less than shape rendering overhead, and as a result, our program is much more efficient. Now, whenever we draw the shape, we also set the previous to current. Okay, let's test it out now. As you can see, whenever we change a property, the shape is drawn only once. This trick can be helpful in other situations where you need to do a heavy task inside forever loops like drawing patterns. If you're interested in rendering patterns, you may want to watch this video as well.